Imagine a teenager whose finances are all over the place. Saving appears to be an archaic concept in the rebellious punk idiom listening kid, while splurging money on everything and anything seems to be the right way to go. And if anything goes south, the said teenager has his parents to fall back on. Now imagine all this, dial the entire situation up by a factor of 1,000 or 1,000,000, and you will get a state leader who is currently handling the shady finances of Andhra Pradesh in a similar way. Y.S. Jagmohan Reddy, the CM of Andhra, is the teenage kid who is splurging money right, left and center on minority appeasement. He is availing gargantuan amounts of loans from bank to stuff his precious vote bank. Instead of parents, he turns to the Modi government for funds when the coffers run dry. What YSR Reddy is doing with the finances of Andhra Pradesh could have cataclysmic effects in the future. Hi and welcome, you're watching TFI English, the national socio-political analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I'm your host Tribhuvan, and in this video, I will tell you how Jagmohan Reddy is mishandling Andhra Pradesh's finances and increasing the debt burden on the state just to appease the minority. Why is Jagmohan Reddy and his YSRCP government is going all out to bury the state in massive amount of debt? The union government on Tuesday informed the upper house that since assuming the chair in April 2019, Reddy's government had availed a sum of ₹56,076 crores as loans from various public sector banks. Kanaka Medala Ravindra Kumar of the opposition Telugu Desam Party had posted the question, and Bhagwat Karad, the Minister of State in Ministry of Finance, replies with jaw-dropping numbers. The state already has a debt burden of ₹3,73,140 crore as of November 2020. According to an Economic Times report, the state government borrowed ₹9,226.375 crores on an average per month during the 2020 and 21 financial year. Andhra Pradesh's debt burden was ₹97,000 crores at the time of bifurcation in June 2014. In 5 years, till March 2019, it peaked to ₹2,58,928 crores. Not only this, the Andhra Pradesh government in May, whilst presenting its annual budget for the financial year 2021-22 in the midst of a raging second wave of the pandemic, then let its appeasement politics die down. It allotted a whopping ₹48,000 crore towards implementing 22 freebie schemes. Three of these schemes will cost ₹16,899 crores and will be implemented through the Street Development Corporation. After the freebie politics, the public debt is expected to mount ₹3,87,125 crore, rising from ₹3,55,874 crore in the previous year, as the government targets to borrow ₹50,525 crore afresh. It is also interesting to note that partial and discriminatory allocation of budget to different sections of the society by the Reddy government. The Brahmins have been allocated ₹359 crores, while the minorities have received ₹3,840 crores. While the Andhra government splurges blindly, the central government has to take care of its finances. The Department of Expenditure, Ministry of Finance this week released the fifth monthly installment of post-devolution revenue deficit grant of ₹9,871 crore to states across the country as a recommendation by the Finance Commission. Andhra Pradesh has received ₹1,438.08 crore in the installment, taking its total amount to ₹7,190.42 crores in the year 2021-22. The state is just behind Kerala and West Bengal in terms of funds. It is pertinent to note that the post-devolution revenue deficit grant is provided to the states under Article 275 of the Constitution. It is released in monthly tranches to meet the gap in revenue accounts of the state post-devolution. Such has been the extent of minority appeasement in Jagan's Andhra Pradesh that the benefits meant for the members of SC-ST communities have been usurped by the converted Christians, with pastors gulping down the lion's share. As reported by TFI, Minister of State for Social Justice and Empowerment A. Narayanaswamy had to release a statement and give an earful to the Andhra government. No person who professes a religion different from the Hindu, the Sikh, or the Buddhist religion shall be deemed to be a member of a scheduled caste. The benefits of centrally sponsored scheme meant for the welfare and development of scheduled caste cannot be extended to converted Christians from scheduled castes. According to several reports, majority of Christian converts, around 80%, are from the SC community and have continued availing benefits meant for SCs. Allotment of land, house, free electricity and loans are usurped by Christian converts via the 1977 orders that extends SC reservation benefits to Christian converts in violation of the constitutional provision of 1950. As per the data obtained through RTI, it was revealed that 58.14% of Christian pastors have Hindu SC community certificates and 13.37% of Christian pastors have Hindu OBC community certificates. Reddy's explicit pro-minority stance in any case has always been a harsh reality for state Hindus. In December 2019, the Andhra Pradesh government made an attempt for a hostile takeover of the Ahobilam temples, quite obviously for the lucrative benefits. Now the state government is mulling to convert the temple compound into a tourist location, more certainly at the expense of the temple and its historic significance. The Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam's contribution to the Andhra Pradesh state government had spiked from Rs 2.5 crore to Rs 50 crore in the month of January last year, suggesting that the government was quietly looting the temple. Reported by TFI last year, Y.V. Subba Reddy, the chairman of the TTD Board Trust, also the maternal uncle of CM Jagannathan Reddy, had decided to sell off close to 50 immovable assets to the Tirupati Temple Board across various states. The decision naturally brought the ire of the devotees who did not donate their hard-earned money, only to see a Christian appeasant chief minister sell away the temple lands. However, strong backlash from Pawan Kalyan and Hindu devotees at the time led the Jagan government to take a step back from the decision. Perhaps it is through his minority appeasement politics that Jagannathan Reddy has managed to fill his personal coffers as well. As also reported by TFI, the YSR Congress leader is the prime accuser in over 10 charge sheets filed by CBI and ED of disproportionate asset cases worth Rs 43,000 crore. It is alleged that Jagan Reddy's income rose from measly Rs 11 lakh in 2004 to Rs 43,000 crore by the time his father died. Thus, one can understand why the state of Andhra Pradesh is in such dire straits. The debt is mounting and the chief minister is sleeping at the wheel. However, when awake, he is busy simply mollycoddling his smooth path.